An emotional day for the family of a Phoenix man shot and killed by a DPS trooper on Memorial Day.
Deion Johnson's family held his funeral service in South Phoenix earlier today, but they still do not have answers to many questions surrounding Johnson's death. It's good to have you with us. I'm Mitch Carr alongside Caribe Devine. Mark Curtis has the night off.
Team 12's Erica Stapleton has been following this story from the start. And Erica, what's next for Deion's family?
Even though Deion Johnson has been laid to rest, his family says they're not going to stop pushing for justice.
You are my everything.
The funeral for 28-year-old Deion Johnson. The pain of his death still raw.
My heart hurts.
For his mother, Irma.
It's like a razor sliced my heart open.
His memory forever marked by how he died.
I would have taken that bullet for you.
Phoenix police, who took over the investigation, say a trooper found Deion Johnson passed out drunk in his parked car, blocking part of the road near Loop 101 in Tatum. Police say the trooper removed a gun he saw in the car, and when he went to arrest Johnson, Johnson reached through the window and grabbed at the trooper and his gun, which ultimately led to the trooper shooting Johnson.
However, without body or dash cams, Johnson's family fears this case is one-sided.
I will always love you. I will get justice.
Demands for justice in his death illuminated with a vigil and amplified by thousands who marched last weekend to DPS headquarters.
Deion Johnson!
But Friday's tone, much more somber.
Dad, we got so much pain.
Deion's 14-year-old daughter.
We gotta look how far we came.
Trying to push through the pain of not just today, but the ongoing investigation.
And we gotta be strong for him, because that was our rock.
Despite family demands, investigators have not released the name of the DPS trooper that shot Johnson, but they do say he is on paid administrative leave while the case continues. We're in Phoenix, Erica Stapleton, 12 News.
All right, Erica, thank you.